One of the most revealing statements from this modest teacher is, "My accomplishments are reflected in the deeds of people that I have been fortunate to teach. They are doing things that I, as one person, could never do." Photos of young George show him wearing his good outfits, learning human relations, and always with his best foot forward, as in this shot of the Michigan State 1951 freshman track team. He's fourth from the right in the first row. It was during those undergraduate years that Barbara and George met and were married. It was also time for an Air Force hitch. Decades later, he would be chosen as distinguished guest lecturer at the Air Force Academy. George says that he teaches other people's children with the permission of his kids, 7 children, 6 grandchildren, and 1 great-grandchild. The 5 generations took every opportunity for a party. In 1969, George was appointed the Sylvan N. Goldman Professor of Human Relations, Professor of Education, and Associate Professor of Sociology. In 1970, he was elevated to Chair of the Department of Human Relations. In rapid succession, George was appointed a David Ross Boyd Professor, a Regents Professor, a Kerr McGee Presidential Professor, and Director of the Human Relations Advanced Program. George has published 29 books and 70 articles. The new Henderson-Tolson Cultural Center was opened this past year. During the presentation of the Distinguished Service Award, George gave us his definition of progress.
And there have been changes. Consequently, I know the meaning of the old slave saying, "We ain't what we want to be, we ain't what we ought to be, we ain't what we're gonna be, but thank God we ain't what we was."